Morning, everybody. Welcome to the second in our series, Western Performs, series of concerts organized. Our third in the series, Western Performs. I mean humanities, I can't count. Which are a series of concerts organized during the year between the School for Advanced Studies for the Arts and Humanities, SASAH, and the music faculty and that I've organized with my colleagues, Joel Faflick and Sharon Way. Today's a special concert in many ways because this is, of course, International Week at Western. And as a result, we have not only a very international concert, one of the things that we celebrate here at Western is the extraordinary diversity among our student population, among these young people who do such fine work. But also this for this concert, we have the collaboration of not just SASAH, the music faculty, the library, for whom, thanks to Catherine Wilkins, we have this wonderful space and such support, but also this time, the Department of Modern Languages and the French Department. So this is truly an international collaboration for tonight, for today's concert. That's all I want to say. I want to hand over the stage to our participants, and the first of whom is, I'm happy to say,
But you're still happy to say.
I'm happy to say. I'm always happy to say things. What is the first thing? Okay, each person introduces him or herself.
My name is Olena Bratishko, and I am a DMA, a collaborative piano student in the music department, and I'm from Ukraine. So I will play a piece by Ukrainian composer Miroslav Skorik. He's a living composer, born in 1938, used a lot of folk tunes in his compositions. He's also a pianist and a conductor. Just some interesting fact about his life. He was born in Lviv, which is a western part of Ukraine, but in 1938 he was a part of Poland at that time, and his parents got education in Vienna, Austria. And his great aunt was Solomia Kushelnitska, which was one of the greatest Ukrainian singers, opera singers. And unfortunately, in 1947, his family was deported to Siberia by the Soviet regime, and it was there where he spent almost his childhood, most of his childhood. And then they came back to Lviv in 1955. Right now he teaches in Lviv Conservatory, and he's very busy with his musical life. So, and this piece that I'm playing is actually, it's considered a spiritual hymn of Ukraine, especially considering the late, the last events that happened in my country. And he composed this music to the film The High Pass. So that's the music from the movie. But it's very, very popular.
Thank you. third-year PhD candidate in comparative literature. So today I'm going to recite Ferdinand Vassilian Aguirre's poem Uthar, which is translated into Borrowing Morning and Blended Night. सवेरे उठा तो धूप खिलकर छा गई थी और एक चिड़िया अभी अभी गा गई थी। मैंने धूप से कहा, मुझे थोड़ी गरमाई दोगी उधार? चिड़िया से कहा, थोड़ी मिठास उधार दोगी? मैंने घास की पत्ती से पूछा, तनिक हरियाली उधार दोगी? तिनके की नोक पर शंख पुष्पी से पूछा, उजास दोगी किरण की ओक पर? मैंने हवा से मांगा थोड़ा खुलापन, बस एक प्रश्वास, लहर से एक रोम की सिरहन भरी उल्लास। मैंने आकाश से मांगी आँख की चक्की भर असीमता उधार। सबसे उधार मांगा, सबने दिया, यूं मैं जिया हूँ और जीता हूँ, क्योंकि यही सब तो है जीवन, गरमाई, मिठास, हरियाली, उजाला, गंधवाही, मुक्त खुलापन, लोच, उल्लास, लहरत प्रवाह और बोध भव्य निवास नसीम का ये सब उधार पाए हुए द्रव्य। रात के अकेले अंधकार में सामने से जागा, जिसमें एक अनदेखे अरूप ने पुकार कर मुझसे पूछा था, क्यों जी तुम्हारे इस जीवन के इतने विविध अनुभव हैं, इतने तुम धनी हो तो मुझे थोड़ा प्यार दोगे उधार, जिसे मैं 100 गुने सूद के साथ लौटाऊंगा, और मैं भी 100-100 बार गिन के जब जब मैं आऊंगा। मैंने कहा, प्यार उधार? स्वर अचकचाया था क्योंकि मेरे अनुभव के से परे था ऐसा व्यवहार। उस अनदेखे अरूप ने कहा, हाँ, क्योंकि ये ही सब चीजें तो प्यार हैं, यह अकेलापन, यह अकुलाहट, यह असमंजस, अचकचाहट, आत्र अनुभव, यह खोज, यह द्वैत, यह असहाय गृह व्यथा, यह अंधकार में जाकर सहसा पहचानना के जो मेरा है वही ममेत्र है। यह सब तुम्हारे पास है तो थोड़ा मुझे दे दो उधार, इस बार एक बार मुझे जो चरम आवश्यकता है। उसने यह कहा, पर रात के घुप अंधेरे में मैं सहमा हुआ, चुप रहा, अभी तक मौन हूँ। अनदेखे अरूप को उधार देते मैं डरता हूँ, कौन जाने ये याचक कौन है।
Des bords de Valmore. And this piece is, some people can interpret it as requited love. I find that it is more of the women at the time period of the poet from around the 1880s, 1890s, where life for them may seem beautiful, yet there's also kind of like the dark side to their story. Like, for instance, a woman who's madly in love with her husband, yet her husband could be beating her either publicly or privately, and she's trying to sort of endure through, like, just keep going no matter the pain or no matter the situation. I hope you enjoy the piece.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. My name is Cesar. I am from Mexico, and Yolanda is also from Mexico, and myself. We'll be performing five songs for children. The poetry is by Garcia Lorca, and the music by the Mexican composer Silvestre Revueltas. I'll tell you a little bit about the translation of each one of the poems as I go. The first one, it's El Caballito. So El Caballito says, translates to little horse, and it's this little horse that you're drawing the cart. Tell me, how do you make your hair look so beautiful and shiny? And the little horse responds, by sweating.
Thank you.
last song he sang is called El Lagarto, which is the lizard. And it says, Mr. Lizard and Mrs. Lizard have lost their wedding ring. So they are very sad and are crying. The sun and the birds look at them. Oh, look at how old the lizards are, and see them all weeping.
Literature, and today I will be reciting a poem by Furukhfar Rokhzad. She is an Iranian poet. It's a poem about love, life, and it's addressed to a beloved who is not there anymore. همه هستی من آیه تاریکی است که تو را تکرار کنان به سحرگاه شکفتنها و رستنهای ابدی خواهد بود. من در این آیه تو را آه کشیدم، آه. من در این آیه تو را به درخت و آب و آتش پیوند زدم. زندگی شاید یک خیابان دراز است که هر روز زنی با زنبیلی از آن می گذرد. زندگی شاید ریسمانی است که مردی با آن خود را از شاخه می آویزد. زندگی شاید طفلی است که از مدرسه برمیگردد. زندگی شاید افروختن سیگاری باشد در فاصله رغبتناک دو هم‌آغوشی، یا عبور گیج رهگذری باشد که کلاه از سر برمی‌دارد و به یک رهگذر دیگر با لبخندی بی‌معنی می‌گوید صبح بخیر. زندگی شاید آن لحظه مسدودی است که نگاه من در نینی چشمان تو خود را ویران می سازد و در این حسی که من آن را با ادراک ماه و با دریافت ظلمت خواهم آورد. در اتاقی که به اندازه یک تنهایی است، دل من که به اندازه یک عشق است به بهانه های ساده خوشبختی خود می نگرد، به زوال زیبای گلها در گلدان، به نهالی که تو در باغچه خانه من کاشتی و به آواز قناری ها که به اندازه یک پنجره می خواند. آه، سهم من این است، سهم من این است. سهم من آسمانی است که آویختن پرده آن را از من می گیرد. سهم من پایین رفتن از یک پله متروک است و به چیزی در پوسیدگی و قربت واصل گشتن و در اندوه صدایی جان دادن که به من می گوید دست هایت را دوست می دارم. دست هایم را در باغچه می کارم سبز خواهم شد می دانم می دانم می دانم و پرستوها در گودی انگشتان جوهریم تخم خواهند گذاشت گوشواری به دو گوشم می آویزم از دو گیلاس سرخ همزا و به ناخنهایم برگ گل کوکب می چسبانم کوچه ای هست که در آنجا پسرانی که به من عاشق بودند هنوز با همان موهای درهم و گردنهای باریک و پاهای لاغر به تبسمهای دخترکی می اندیشند که یک شب باد او را با خود برد کوچه ای هست که قلب من آن را از محله های کودکیم دزدیده است سفر حجمی در خط زمان و به حجمی خط خشک زمان را آبستن کردن حجمی از تصویری آگاه که زمهمانی یک آینه برمیگردد و بدین سان است که کسی میمیرد و کسی میماند هیچ صیادی در جوی حقیری که به گودالی میریزد مرواریدی سیف نخواهد کرد من پری کوچک غمگینی را میشناسم که در اقیانوسی مسکن دارد و دلش را در یک نیلبک چوبین می نوازد آرام آرام پری کوچک غمگینی که شب از یک بوسه می میرد و سحرگاه از یک بوسه به دنیا خواهد آمد Thank you
Hello, my name is Simona Jenga. I'm a fourth-year performance major at the Don Wright Faculty of Music. I was born in Canada, but both sets of my grandparents, immigrated from Italy, so I have a lot of Italian heritage and still have a lot of family in Italy. The piece Elena and I will be performing for today is from Bellini's Sei Arietta da Camera, and this piece is entitled Almen se non posio. So the English translation is, if I am at least unable to be with my love, I will still send warm wishes to him.
Almen se non posio. Anyway, everyone, this is a This is a Kenya Rwanda word for good morning. My name is Clarice. I am currently a health science student. This May, I had the opportunity of participating in the International Service Learning course offered by Henri Boyi. And while I was there in Rwanda, I fell completely in love with the culture and the people, and consequently learned Kenya Rwanda, kind of, in the 5.5 short weeks. So I will be reciting a poem for peace in Kenya Rwanda. Umuvogo wa mahoro, mumajwi bil. Mahoro tamboka. Amambere mumasesa amahoro akambuka mbere ibini. Mahoro tamboka. Kwigihanga amahoro araza ingio nyoni itukura. Kugashami kumakara kuzabari taze. Mahoro tamboka. Mwijoro amahoro araza, buhuku arira nora, bukita akivugurura. Mahoro tamboka. Irara wajanye zumuhondo munzu itoro rituje. Mahoro tamboka. None mahoro ingwinu uhangane na mahana. Mahoro tamboka. Markoze.
Bonjour, bon après-midi. I'm Henri Boyi. I teach in the French Studies Department. My name is Henri Boyi. I teach in the French Studies Department. And as Clarice said, I also teach a course on international community service learning where I've been taking students to Rwanda. It's been 6 years and we are getting ready for the 7th year, going for 5 weeks to do community service learning in Rwanda. I'm going to recite the same poem that Clarice just recited, a poem for peace. And you all know that today, as we speak, as we stand here, the world needs peace. Turirimbe Amahoro mumajwi abiri. Amahoro yarasasagaye azatagira gahonzi kare mu gatondo atakarakoma. Ingo amahoro atagira gahonzi. Amahoro yarasasagaye ryaka akanyoni gahagaze kugisanga sanga cyirabura izuba ryaka ingoma horo atagira gahunzi amahoro yarasasagaye mu bicugu azanyigorora nk'akayabo yigorora adaheza ingoma horo atagira gahunzi Amahoro yarasasagaye amashugwe akwira hose abantu bibogoye Ingoma horo atagira gahonzi nuze mahoro atagira gahonzi nuze mahoro atagira gahonzi
Thank you. Library Faculty, SASAH. I'm Yolanda, and this is Francisco, and we're both from Mexico, and we're doing a DMA in music in Western, and we are performing a song by a Mexican composer, Manuel M. Ponce. This song was, it's actually an arrangement for violin and piano, and it was arranged by Joshua Heifetz. And there's this whole story that he was at a coffee shop in Mexico City, and he was about performing or something, and he listened to this song on the radio, and he decided to make an arrangement for violin and piano. And basically the poem talks about this person who's singing to the stars, and he's saying like, oh, my little star, I'm suffering, and you know all of my pain and everything I've been through, and all I want you to do is just to come down and tell me you love me, because I love you and I just don't want to die without you. Thank you.
Just down the hill, and I wanted to say thank you all so much for coming today. It's been such a pleasure for me to help organize the series along with Joel Fachlack and Lawrence Deleuze. And I want to say a special thank you to Professor John Hess and Patricia Green today for helping to organize the musical selections that you heard. I just wanted to let you know that our December concert is a little bit different. It starts at 10 a.m., which I realize conflicts with a lot of your schedules. But the reason why is we're working in collaboration with the first year philosophy class, which happens at the same time, and they are examining the question, what is music? And so we have a very special piece prepared to kind of present to that class. So we'll be here from about 10 to 11 o'clock on December 8th. But we're coming back in January at our regular time, 11:30. We're going to have previews from Falstaff, the opera that Western's producing in January. February, there's chamber music, as well as our early music out of the studio ensemble. So I hope to see all of you again when we come back in the new year. We also have a concert at Aeolian Hall. Then our very last one is a special kind of interdisciplinary collaboration on March 10th, which is a Thursday evening in the IGAP building, which is just down the hill. But for right now, I'd love to say a great big thank you to all of our musicians and our speakers. If you guys could come back up and take one more bow.